Hey there, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, Dizzy Course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the introduction of a Google Ads. This is completely the introduction of a Google Ads and it is a part one. So here I'll be talking about Google Ads, what exactly the Google Ads mean and how it works, SEO versus Google Ads, structure of SERP, Google Ad Networks, advantages and its account structure. So we will be going through the basics of Google Ads in this part one section. I have also created a continuation videos of this part one. Do watch those continuation videos of this Google Ads as well, so that you will be getting a clear idea in depth about this Google Ads. Now let's get started.
So what is Google Ads? Okay, by the name implies here, the name implies Google Ads, it's an advertising platform. So basically, it is provided by a Google itself. Okay. I will show you on a diagram now. I'll show you a diagram so that you will understand very clearly. Google Ads, it's just a platform, okay, an advertising platform, and it is not a free, okay. It is completely a paid version, paid advertising tool, we call it as a. If you want to push an advertisement, so you will be depending on this Google Ads, whereas SEO is completely a free organic, whereas Google Ads, it's completely a paid tool, okay. See now, this is a Google Ads platform. Okay, by using this Google Ads platform, Google will show the ads in Google properties. Or we call it as a Google platforms also. And it will show the ads in Google partners also. So Google partners and Google properties, we have two things over here. So you might have known what are these Google properties. Your ad will appear in search engine. So now Google is a, we have a Google search engine, you already know. So everyone know this. So your ad will appear in a search engine that is called Google property. And your ad will appear in Android apps. That is also Google property. We already know we have a Google Play Store, right? So your ad appears in Android apps. And you know, YouTube is also a property of a Google, or like a few properties of a Google. So now by using this Google Ads platform, we are going to show the ads in a Google properties. So whereas what are these Google partners? So you might have noticed ads in the websites also sometimes. So basically, so in order to show ads in a search engine, you don't need to have any permissions. Why? Because the search engine itself, it's a Google's, and then Android apps also, it's a Google's only, then YouTube also. Whereas the websites are not owned by a Google. So now Dizzy Course is there. Dizzy Course is owned by me. Amazon is there. Amazon is owned by some other else. Those are websites not owned by a Google. But in some website, you might have seen some ads also. Those are Google ads again. So how those websites are giving up permissions for a Google again, and how Google is able to show ads in those websites. That are called simply the partners, and in depth, how exactly the Google is going to connect with the websites, what is the medium that Google is going to use it, everything we're going to discuss in depth when that section comes. So websites. By this, in simple words, if I can say about this Google Ads, it just acts like a bridge, or else it just acts like a medium where we can show the advertisements on different Google properties and different Google partners. Okay, this is what just simply Google Ads. In order to show my ad on all these platforms, we have to pay money to Google. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how it works actually. So how it works means basically it works on auction system. Auction system means, I'll show you now. Okay, let us say that according to the study, I can say that there are like a 2.3 million people are searching for every second on Google. Okay, now let's say I am the one who is another 2.3 million people. So I'm just going to search for a data train. Okay. So I'm just searching for a keyword. Like I am a person over here. I am thinking. So I would like to join a training of big data. So definitely I'll be using a browser called Google and I'll be searching here. Okay. So whenever someone searches for a keyword, so Google will show the advertisements on top if you can see here. Okay. So edureka.co and cloudxlab.com, intellipath.com, and then ematicus.org. So what are these? If you can see an AD text written over here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So Google is displaying a 4 ads in a SERP now. Okay, got it. So how it works means based on auction. Okay, so here there are 4 competitors, 1, 2, 3, 4. So why this Google is placing this website only on top? Why? Because there are four advertisers. So why it is showing only partiality for this website means it paid more. Okay. The more the bidding, the highest the position is simply. Okay. He paid more when compared to other three people. So that's the reason his website is on top. So again, this is not only the factor that Google considered to show up the website on top. There are many other factors like quality score, CTR. So I'm not going to teach you in depth about these quality score CTR now itself in the first section. No. So let me go with the basics actually. So now when a person sees your ad, I'm not going to pay money to Google. Now assume that this is my ad. Okay. I have pushed my ad using Google Ads. So my ad is appearing here in SERP on top. Whenever my ad appears on top or somewhere in SERP, I'm not going to pay money. Whenever someone click my ad, then only I'm going to pay. Okay. This is called a CPC. Or you can call it as a PPC. Cost per click. See here, my ad, this is my ad. Assume that this edureka.co is my site. I have pushed my ad by using Google Ads platform in SERP. So that means I am paying money to Google. Hey, Google, please show up my site on top in SERP whenever someone searches for a keyword called big data training. So simply it works in such a way that your ad will appear for a relevant keyword that you choose to be appeared. Now I have chosen that my ad has to be appeared for a keyword called big data training on top. Okay. So now whenever my ad appears on top, I'm not going to pay anything. Whenever my ad gets clicked. Okay. Now big data training, my ad got appear. I don't pay anything. When someone clicked my ad only, I'll be paying money to Google. That is what simply the bidding strategy CPC. Okay. So here you will be learning lot of vocabularies. So CPC is like a cost per click. That means I am going to pay only per click, not for when my ad appears. Okay. So when your ad appears, that is called CPM. CPM means cost per 1,000 impressions. Now, when I search for a big data training, this ad got appear. So now if it is appearing for a keyword means, then it is gaining one impression. This ad also got one impression. This ad also got impression. This ad also got one impression. So that overall, these ads got a 111 impressions. Okay. In such a way, how many times your ad appears for the keyword, that many impressions that Google will calculate. Simply the impressions means your ad appears, clicks means when your ad got clicked. So now are you paying money for impressions or click? Yes,
click.
For click.
You are paying per click. Okay, that is what CPC. Again, yes, we do have a many other bidding strategies like CPC, CPM. Okay, so in depth, we're going to discuss about that also. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the difference between SEO versus PPC, like SEO versus PPC. why I have to, I'm already doing this SEO, right? Why I have to do again this Google Ads? Many people might think about this. So SEO is considered as completely organic way. If I can see, okay, these are some organic results. Okay, these are some organic results. And SEO is completely free. That means you are not going to pay single amount to show your website on top. Okay, so but yes, of course, it is not going to happen in just one day or 2 days. It is a long-term process. Long-term process, and you know, it requires a high quality content and it requires a lot of backlinks to your site. And I know very well that it is not going to happen in just one day or 2 days. So at that time, so I can't sit idle just by doing SEO, right? So I have to use other platforms in order to promote my business. If it is an e-commerce site, you can't just sit only doing SEO. Why? Because you have to make some immediate sales. And that immediate sales cannot be done using SEO initially. So at the time, I will be using this Google Ads. Google Ads is used for mainly getting some immediate results or instant results. So if you are looking out to have some instant results from your advertisement, like instant sales, instant traffic to your site, then you can choose this Google Ads. In order to run this advertisement, you don't require any high quality backlinks or, you know, high quality content. If you just have a money, then you can go with advertisement, then you can drive a quality traffic to your site, as well as you can make a conversion also. Okay, so that is why we use this Google Ads over SEO. So I'm not saying this SEO is outdated version. Yes, of course, you have to perform both the things parallelly. While doing SEO, do perform this Google Ads also for getting some instant results. Okay, yeah. So this is simply the SEO versus Google Ads. Next, structure of SERP. Can you guys tell me what is the structure of SERP here? You know what is this SERP? SERP means search engine results page. Okay. Here, this is SERP. This is a search engine and I can see a results over there, and it is a page. This is like just a search engine results page. Your structure of SERP may not be constant again. Okay. Many of 90% of your SERP is filled up with the ads on top. Yes or no? Like mostly many people are going with the ads nowadays. So it may show ads on top for some keywords. It may show videos on top for some keywords, and it may show snippets on top. It may show images on top. Sometimes it may show normal websites on top. So again, I'm not saying that a structure of SERP will be constant every time. It keeps on changing according to the query we searched for. So now I'm searching for a big data training. So now it is showing me some advertisements over here. Let me search one more keyword called how to prepare green tea. Okay, how to prepare for UPSC. Okay. Oh, again, I can see some more advertisements over here. Let me go and search for. How to prepare face mask at home. Okay. If you can see, there are again the videos and again the normal websites I can see. So here for this keyword, it is showing me advertisements. For this keyword, it is not showing me the advertisements. So that is what simply the structure. It is not constant. Okay. So let us talk about the structure of SERP, which consisting of some advertisements. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 are ads on top. And in middle, you can see that these are like SEO results only. Okay. And if I still scroll down, can you see on bottom? 1, 2, 3. 3 more ads at the bottom. Okay. So basically 4 ads on and in middle, organic results, and at the bottom, three ads. So overall, how many ads Google will display?
Seven.
Four ads on top and three ads at the bottom. So overall, Google will display as seven ads for a particular keyword. This is like a maximum number of advertisements. So again, it's not mandatory that every time it will show four ads on top. It may show three ads, it may show two ads, it may show one ad also. So sometimes no ads also. Again, at the bottom, it is not mandatory to show up three ads. It may show two or one. Depends on the competition, depends on the advertisers on a particular day. Okay, this is the basic structure of SERP. Next. Google Ads Network. Let us talk about some Google Ads Network. So till now, you came to know what is this Google Ads and how it works, okay? And SEO versus Google Ads and structure of SEO. Google Ads Network, what are the different kinds of networks we have? That means, where are your Google advertisements show up? Okay, so where are the advertisements shown by a Google? Okay, so that I'm going to show you in clear. So first is search network. Okay. Search network means the ads which are appearing in a SERP. Can you see? Okay. These are the ads which appear in SERP and we call it as a search network ads. Okay. Tell me where your ad appears if it is a search network. In? SERP. Okay. Then bidding strategy or bidding type. When you are going to pay money to Google, when you use a search network ad, I am going to pay money to Google when someone click, not when someone sees my ad. Okay. So this is bidding strategy. And what is the format of your ad? It is a in text format. Normally, this search network ads can also be called as a text ads. Okay, you can call it as a text ads or you can call it as a search network ads. Anything is fine. The meaning is like same. Search network ad appears in SERP and bidding strategy is CPC. So do remember that bidding strategy means when you are going to bid. Okay, when you are going to pay. So this is what simply the Google ads mean, right? Bidding, based on a bidding, based on an auction. You are going to bid for some model so that Google will take money when someone makes some actions according to your model. Okay. This is one network. Again, one more network is display network. Noisebook. Have you ever noticed ads in the websites? Let me show you that also. So assume that you've been to this website, okay, and you started reading a blogs over here and you can find advertisements here and there, like top, right side, at the bottom. If I put a cursor on the info, it is showing you ads by a Google. And it is showing you ads by a Google, ads by a Google. The who are pushing these ads? A Google. By using which platform? By Google Ads platform. Okay. So we are going to push an advertisements in the websites by using this Google Ads platform. So from this website, this Google is getting a permission. Again, how to get a permission, which tool we're going to use for getting a permission. So all those things we're going to discuss in the display network section. Okay. So not only in the websites, like while you watch the YouTube video, at the bottom, you can see some banner ad. Have you ever noticed? I'll show you YouTube banner ads. You see here bottom, this is the image, bottom and right side you can see, got it? This is this is, so that you can close it, right? This is called a, again, display network only. Have you ever noticed ads on the website, ads on the mobile apps? While you play any games or while you use any apps, in the middle you can see the image ads and banner ads so that you can close that. Have you ever noticed?
Noticed, ma'am.
Noticed. So those are display network ads. Tell me, your ad appears in websites. Your ad appears in YouTube. Your ad appears in mobile apps. Okay. Then here, bidding type. The bidding type we use for this display network is CPM, cost per 1,000 impressions. That means, impression means when your ad appears. Now I am going to pay money to Google when my ad get 1,000 impressions. That means when your ad appear for 1,000 times, you are going to pay money, not per a click. That is what simply display network. Display network is mostly used for a branding. Okay, now assume that 1 lakh visitors. So there are like 1 lakh visitors daily for this website. Whoever visits this website definitely will see this ad. This is where they are improving some branding over here. So it is not about like driving a sales, like driving a traffic to your site, but 99% of cases, you will be improving the branding. Okay. So for that, we use this display, and bidding type will be CPM. You can choose a CPC also, but mostly like probably will be using this CPM. What is the format of your ad? It can be image or it can be banner. Next, here comes video ads, or we call it as a YouTube ads. This is like, you guys are very familiar with these kind of ads, I hope. Whenever you're about to watch any video on YouTube, you will be facing some advertisements. Whereas after 15 seconds only, after 5 seconds only, you will be able to skip that ad. Have you ever noticed? So can you see the skip option here? Okay. These are called skippable ads. These are called YouTube ads or video ads. Okay. So tell me where your ad appears. If I choose this video ad network, ad appears in
YouTube.
Here comes the bidding type. It's a CPV. Okay. So CPV means cost per view. Okay. So what is this view exactly, and how this Google is going to calculate the view? All these things we're going to discuss in this video ads network section. Okay. So as of now, just remember that this is the bidding type we use for a video ads, cost per view. That means I am going to pay money to Google when I get a view. Okay. Tell me, what is the format of my ad? It's a
video
format. Simple. Next is mobile app ads. Now, let me search for a word called Zomato. Please open your mobile phone and search for the same thing and let me know what you can see over there.
And to install app like this.
So can you see any advertisements?
Yeah.
Open your Play Store again. So search for a text called food delivery apps. Food delivery apps.
Yes, ma'am. We have search.
Yeah. So what you can see? Can you see ad on top?
Yes. Domino's Pizza in down ad. AD.
Advertisements, right?
Yes.
So now open your YouTube on your mobile phone. So I don't hope so. Like exactly you'll be seeing mobile app ads. Have you ever noticed ads on a mobile YouTube? When you browse any YouTube videos, like it will be asking you to install the mobile app. Have you ever? Only on mobile phone I'm talking. not on desktop. Okay. So again, that is also mobile app. And while you browse some content on a websites on a mobile phone, have you ever noticed ads, like banner ads in the websites? So where it will ask you to install it. Have you ever noticed?
Yes.
So those are called the mobile app ads. So mobile app ads are especially for having a more and more installations for your app. Okay. So when you have an app, you can promote your app using this mobile app ads. Okay. So basically tell me where your ad appears. It appears in a mobile SERP. Okay. And it appears on Play Store. And it appears on apps. It appears on YouTube. It appears on websites. Yes or no?
Yes.
Next, what is a bidding type? Bidding type is CPI. CPI means cost per installation. I am going to pay when someone installs my app, not when someone clicks, not when someone sees. I'm just going to pay when someone installs my app. So then what is the format? Tell me. The format can be image. The format can be text. If it is appearing in SERP, it is a text format. If it is appearing in the YouTube, it is a
videos.
Video. Okay. So if it is text, image, and video, that's fine. Right. So these are the formats suitable for a mobile app ads. Next. Shopping network. Now let me show you that example even. Peanut butter. I'm searching for a keyword called peanut butter. Can you see on top? 33% offer, peanut butter, my protein, Amazon, Nutribay, the button, this, and ads. These are called shopping ads. Tell me what type of ad it is again. This is a search network ad. This is a search network, right? And these are called shopping ads. Shopping ads are used by an e-commerce websites, only by e-commerce websites, again, not any other service-oriented websites like DigiCourse. So it will be used by Amazon and Flipkart's kind of websites who have some products to sell, okay? So this ad will appear in a SERP, okay? And it will show you the price tag and it will show you the image also, whereas in text ad, In search network ad, it just show you the text. Whereas shopping ads, it will show you the image of a product, name of a product, price tag, and the website also. Okay, so in this section, we're gonna see how to create these kind of a shopping ads and how to show up in SERP and how exactly we are going to pay money for this shopping advertisements. Okay, so tell me where your ad appears.
SERP.
What is the bidding type? CPC. We are going to pay when someone click on my shopping ad. So what is the format? Image.
Image, text.
Text. Right. So these are the different kinds of networks we have. Advantages of Google Ads. So now you came across like what exactly this Google Ads and what are the different kinds of networks available. But why exactly, what are the few advantages we have in this Google Ads is, so you can get a good ROI, return on investment. Okay. Assume that your product is $1. Okay. Your product price is $1. So, okay, $1, it would be like cheap. I'll go with the $20. Your product price is like a $20 and you have performed a search network. That means you are going to show up ads in a SERP. And your cost per click is just $1. Okay, your cost per click is just $1. That means you are going to pay when someone click on your ad. Okay, so out of, let's say it's like a $1, right? You have a 10 clicks. Tell me how many dollars now? 10 clicks is equals to?
$10.
$10. That means how much you are putting a budget here? Your investment is like a $10. Okay, out of $10, like out of 10 clicks, 1% got converted. That means 1% purchased your product. That means if 1% purchases your product, how much the price of your product? It's a $20. $20. That means the investment is $10. How much return you are getting?
$10,
right? So return on investment here. So you can expect a good return on investment here. So according to your investment, you can get a good returns over here. Okay. So that is what I can easily calculate the return on investment as well. Now, let's say I have put a budget like a 4,000 rupees. How much conversions I got in return? So how much exactly this Google has deducted from my account? So where it got deducted? How many clicks I got? How many impressions you got? So from which device you got impressions? Everything it will tell you. And one more advantage is geography. So I can target my people according to the geographical location as well. Whereas SEO, it's like, you know, yes, of course I can target, but it takes a long time, right? So I have to choose a location of a website. I have to do some link building and all. Whereas instantly you can select the location of a people. Now I want to show my ad only for a Hyderabadis. I want to show my ad only for United Kingdoms. So in such a way, you can target according to the geographical locations and according to the time zone and according to the device also. Now I would like to show, let's say my business is all about Android apps. Okay. So I'll just show my ad only for a people who uses mobile phone, and I never show my ad to the desktop who uses desktop. That means who browses something on device or desktop or laptops. Okay, that means you can reach out the audience exact with the device also, like, so in which device you want to show the ad, and you can analyze. Analytics is very, very important here. So you can analyze from pin to pin what exactly happening. Okay, how much the budget you gave, how much it got detected, where it got detected, how many campaigns you have created. So everything you can analyze here. This is like a very much great advantage you're going to have with a Google Ads. Okay. Right. So now let me give you a simple account structure of this Google Ads. Why? Because we can't directly jump into this Google Ads platform in order to create advertisement. First of all, you should know the steps, how you have to enter into this Google Ads. Okay. Let me give you a proper structure now. First thing is to create an account in the Google Ads. You have to create an account in the Google Ads interface. Okay. Next is to create a campaigns. Now I am going to create a campaigns. Next is to create an ad group. So after ad groups, I am going to create a keywords. Next level is keyword level. Next level is ad. Excuse me for my diagram, okay? Please don't mind. Let me just draw something. Right. So having an account is simply mean by you are going to open an account in a Google Ads using your Gmail account. Okay, using your Gmail ID, you will be opening an account in Google Ads. The next thing is to create a campaigns. Okay, what is this campaigns? So in the campaign level, we are going to perform many activities, but just one activity I'm just representing as a campaign is a location. Just remember, that means in which location you want to show up your ad is just mean by a campaigns. So apart from this location, we are going to do many things in this campaign level. The majority of the campaign level is like location. I am going to use a locations in this campaign. That means where you want to show. I want to show in Hyderabad. I want to show in Bangalore. I want to show in United States. Whatever the location, where you want to showcase your ad. The next thing is ad groups. Ad groups is simply what kind of services you are providing, what kind of products you are selling. Now, if it is a DizzyCourse, DizzyCourse.in website, I will be mentioning like SEO ad group, SMM ad group, and then website designing ad group. Okay. So what type of trainings? Whereas my website is consisting of all about trainings. I'll be just distributing, like I'll be creating a multiple ad groups to the relevant category, like SEO ad group, SMM ad group, Google Ads ad group. In such a way, I'll be creating an ad group. It just represents the service you provide or products you sell. Then whereas keyword level represents for which keyword you want to trigger your ad. Whereas here I just searched for a peanut laptops, right? So that means I have choose to that laptop as my keyword, so that whenever someone searches for a laptop keyword, I would like to trigger my ad in a CRP. Okay, that is what you're going to mention. This keyword level represents for which keyword you would like to trigger your ads. Then finally, it's an ad. Ad means final, the structure of your ad. This is like a shopping network ad. This is like a search network ad. Overall, this structure, can you see? So how to create this kind of a structure for each and every network that comes under ad level. So final process is like creating an ad. Okay, so account, campaigns, ad groups, keywords, and ads. Okay, so do remember that with the one Gmail ID, with the one Gmail account, I can create a 20 Google ad accounts with one Gmail ID. Okay, assume that you have like 20 clients. Okay. So at the time, for each and every client, you can't go and create a 20 Gmail IDs. So earlier, this with this Google Ads, we used to create a one Google Ad account with a one Gmail ID. So now it got updated and it is giving us a chance of creating a 20 Google Ad accounts with one Gmail ID. So that now let's say I have a 5 clients, I can maintain those 5 clients under one Gmail ID. Okay, so that is what 20 Google Ads account you can have. Next, under each and every account, I can have a 10,000 campaigns. Okay, that means you can target multiple locations. So under each and every account, 10,000 campaigns you can have. Under each and every ad group, under each and every campaign, you can have up to 20,000 ad groups. Again, under each and every ad group, you can add up to 20 keywords. 20 is like a healthy number of keywords, okay? Don't use more than 20. Under each and every ad group, I'm saying, okay? Next is ad. You can create a 50 ads under each and every ad group. So this is simply the account structure. 20 ad accounts with one Gmail ID, 10,000 campaigns under each and every account, 20,000 ad groups each for each and every campaign, and 20 keywords for every ad group, and 50 ads for every ad group. Okay, so this is just a structure of Google Ads, so that if you know this account structure, then it would be easy for you to create all the campaigns. ads. Finally, this is what the Google Ads basics, the introduction of a Google Ads, how it works, what exactly it means. Okay, so I hope you got a clear idea about these things. So hope you like this video, guys. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.